गुड आफ्टरनून एवरी वन. वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑन क्वान्टिटेटिव एप्टीट्यूड वेयर विल डिस्कस एस बी आई क्लर्क प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर फॉर द ईयर 2020. सो दिस इज योर क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. टेल मी द आंसर गाइज, वेरी फास्ट डू इट, टेल मी द आंसर. सो यू विल गेट हार्डली 2 मिनट्स to solve one question. It can be some question you can do in 1 minute, some question you can do in 3 minutes. So that average you need to maintain. So 18 into 24, I know the 18 table, 18 fours are 72, 18 twos are 36, so I'll get 432. 13 square is 169, so 432 minus 169, how much I'll get? I'll get 263. This is 263 plus 40%. 40% is what? 2 by 5, 18 into 25. So this is 5 za. So 263 plus 180 I need to do. If I do, I'll get the answer called 443. So these kind of questions are called simplification. Nowadays, every exam, you will get a question on simplification. Okay, and they're not difficult. They're based on board mass. Okay, they're based on board mass, concept. Don't tell me that you don't know basic maths, plus minus you don't know. So you can do them very easily. Already I sent you this practice manual to all of you to solve these questions which are based on board mass. So I don't know how much sincerely you have solved this, but these are very important. Already these questions are sent in your group. If you have not seen, if you are in different world, I really request all of you to come to this world. And please see these questions, solve these questions, send me your answer. Okay. And if you have any doubt with any question, I'll help you. But these are very basic simplification based questions. Please don't live in that world that you can't solve these questions. Okay. Question number two, tell me the answer for that. Very good, Harish. Very good, Shruti. You no need to send answer privately. You can send directly. If others can't do, so anyway they can't do. So 45% of 360, don't waste your time finding 45 by 100 into 360. Don't do that. See, understand, 45% is nothing but 50% minus 5%. 50% of 360 would be 180, and 5% is what? 10% of that, that is 18. So what you'll get? You'll get 162. This is 162. This is 162 plus 625, which is 25 square, plus 16 square, which is 256. Okay, so you can add this. This is 8 plus 5, 13, 1 carry. This is 11, 13, 14, 1 carry. This is 8, 9, 10, 103 minus 170. So you can do what you will get. This is 7, this is 873, option A. Very good, Harish. So these things everyone can do. It's not like Harish can do or Shruti can do or XYZ person can do. Everyone can do these kind of questions. I believe you're sitting with pen and pencil and you're prepared to what we are doing. So we'll do it this fast. Please explain at the end of the day saying that the sir has done fast, because this question, if you do slow, then there's no point of understanding it. Then you will complain saying that a 2 minute question sir was doing in 10 minutes. I hope this you can understand the seriousness of this problem. Question number third, what is the answer? What is the square root of 1089? You should know that square root of 1089 is 33. In case you don't know 1089 square root, so make a pair like this. Think of a number square is 10 or value less than 10, that you know the 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16. So then you add them, 3 plus 3 6, and 3 3s are 9. You this will get 189. Then put a digit next to 6, you multiply with the same digit so that you get 189 or a value lesser than 189. So you'll put 63 3s is 189, so you'll get the value called 30. So 33 into 5 is 165. you have to find what? You have to find 165% of 2000. That you have to subtract with 1205. So 165% of 2000 would be what? 165 twos are, I hope you are understanding. You get 330, right? So 160 twos are is what? 320. So this would be 330. So 330. So 330 or 3300. So 165%. So you will get 3300 minus 1205. So you do 1205 with this. 5, you'll get 9, you'll get 0, and you'll get 2095. 2095, you get this. This is 2095. So this is 2095. You'll get this is 20. So this is suppose x square minus 405 is 2095 something. Yeah. So this is what is x square, that is 2095 plus 405. So you'll get is 2500. X square is 2500. So what is the value of x? 50. Anyone, any doubt? Clear, right? So this is 33. 33 into 5. This is what? This is 165%. What is 165% of 2000? 3300. You'll get this as 330. 3300 minus 1205. You'll get 2095. Find the value of x square. So the x value is 50. Anyone, any doubt? You want me to do it again? Anyone, any question? Clear, can I go ahead? Guys, please reply. Use your fundamental rights to talk. Ask me, anyone, any doubt? Clear, can I go ahead? Everyone, all the people who are listening to me, is this clear? Anushri, Chaitra, Chandan, Deepika, Devraj, Devika, Harish, Jayashree, Lakshmikant, anyone, any doubt? Supreet, Yamuna, Arpita, Sushma, Triveni, Vijayalakshmi, Yamuna Lakshmi, anyone, any doubt? Clear, right? Any point you did not understand? Question number 4. So x percent of 800. So where is, can you do this? You people try first. Question number 4. Guys, tell me the answer fast. This much time if you take, it's not good. X percent of 800 is what? X percent of 800. X percent of 800 means x by 100 into 800 means what? This is 8x is equal to 980 minus 348. What is 980 minus 348? This is 3. This is 632. So 8x is 632. So what is the value of x? 8756. So you'll get 72. 8 nines are 72. The answer is 79. Very good, Harish. Clear, everyone. Others, why they are not replying? tell me the answer of this. See, this kind of question, SBI PO, the clerk exam, other IB, IRB, all the banks, you get minimum 5 to 10 questions based on simplification. You want more questions, already I have sent you the Word document having in total 100 questions on simplification. Solve those questions, ask your doubt. Do hard work, everyone. This way or that way, you know how to pass in exam. So getting job is not like passing in some Bangalore, in some university exam paper. It is very different job altogether. What is 9 square minus 7 square? So you can use A square minus B square. What is A square minus A, B square? A minus B into A plus B. 9 plus 7 is 16 and 9 minus 7 is 2. So 9 square minus 7 square is 32. 32 plus 67 is 99. 99 minus 64. So that is what? That is 35. Anyone, any doubt, any question? Or you can do it like, see, 9 square minus 7 square, you're most welcome to do 81 minus 49. You can most welcome, to, you can do like that way. Or you can apply A square minus B square formula. That is A minus B into A plus B. Do this question, question number 6. Anyone, any doubt? Clear? Any doubt, anyone? Please reply, guys. Question number 7. Very good. Supreet, the answer is 1506, Supreet, not 1504. So you can see this. 44 into 50% of 35. So what is 44 into 35? 35 twoza is 70. 40, 35 foza will be 140. So 140. So this would be 1540. 289 divided by 17. Would be 17, 17 square is 289 into 2 means 34. So 1540 minus 34. So you will get 1506. Just do this question number 8. See this, Anushree, 80% of X, 80% of X, okay, minus 50% of 400 means 200 is equal to 600. So means 80% of X is equal to 800. So what would be this value? This would be 10. What is X? X is 1000. Very simple. Anyone, any doubt? Do this question number 9. Very simple. This is 18. This is 128. If you subtract, you will get 110. Okay, so this now 512 minus 110. 512 minus 100 is 412. Again 10. So you get 402. 402 plus x square is 802. So x square is 400. So what is x? X is 20. Clear everyone? Again, very easy problem. See this. 11 square 121, 9 square 81. So how much you are getting? You are getting 202 minus 6. You will get 196. What is square root of 196? 56 divided by 8 is 7. Square root of 196 is 14. 14 is equal to 7x. X is equal to 2. How to remove x square? Kishore is asking how to remove x square. Where you are removing x square? This Kishore, 9 square is 81. 11 square is 121. 121 plus 81 is 202 minus 6. You get 196. So when you solve this, Kishore, when you solve this, you'll get this as 196, under root of 196. This is x into 56 divided by 8. 56 divided by 8 is what? 7x. 7x is under root of 96, means 14. 14, I think everyone knows the square, no? X is equal to 2. I think you should know the square values and all. More you know, better it would be for you. Squares and all, I think everyone should know the values. 11 square 121, 12 square 144, 13 square 169, 14 square 196, 15 square 225, 16 square 256, 17 square 289, 18 square 324. You have to buy her this value, guys. 19 square 369, 21 square 441, 22 square 484, 23 square 529, 24 square 576, 25 square 625, 26 square 676, 27 square 729, 28 square 784, 29 square 841, 31 square 961, 32 square 1024, 33 square 1089. So you have to remember the square values and all. Now this is question number 11. You can see this. So in this question, what you need to do, you need to establish the relation between X and Y. I think everyone knows how to solve a quadratic equation. So 4x square plus 8x plus 3 is equal to 0. So you have to break the middle term, in such a way that when you add, you should get 8x. And when you multiply, you should get 12x square. I think everyone should know this. If you don't know, then probably, so this is 4x square plus 8x plus 3 plus 8x plus 3. So this kind of equation is called quadratic equation. This kind of equation, we call this kind of equation as a quadratic equation. The graph of this equation is a parabola. Now, if you plot the graph of this kind of equation, you will get a parabolic graph. We call them quadratic equation. They are in the form of ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. We call them as a quadratic equation. So how to solve the quadratic equation? Whenever you are getting quadratic equation, although there's a formula is there for that, but in these exams where time is very critical, instead of using formula, you have to break the middle term. The break term, middle term is 8x. So break the middle term in such a way that when you add, you should get 8x. And when you multiply, you should get 12x square. So how will you break 8x? You can break, write 8x as 6x plus 2x. Why? When you add 6x plus 2x, you'll get 8x. And when you multiply them, you'll get 12x square. So 4x square plus 6x plus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. So break the middle term. So if I take 2x common, I'll get 2x plus 3. Here, I can take 1 common. I'll get 2x plus 3 equal to 0. So I'll get 2x plus 1 into 2x plus 3 equal to 0. So once you get this, now you can write 2x plus 1 equal to 0, or you can write 2x plus 3 equal to 0. So the value of x you'll get is minus 1 by 2, or the value of x you'll get is minus 3 by 2. Any doubt anyone till here? Yeah, very good, Spiritic. Any doubt anyone? Everyone understood, right? The value of x you'll get is minus 1 by 2 and minus 3 by 2. So this is the value of x you'll get. Now there's another equation is given to us. So that is 2y square plus 3y plus 1. So break the middle term again the same way. So you can write 3y as 2y plus y plus 1. Is very simple. You are getting 3y, and when you multiply, you should get 2y square. So if I take 2y common, I'll get y plus 1 plus 1 into y plus 1 equal to 0. Get 2y plus 1 into y plus 1 equal to 0. So I'm getting the y value. So 2y plus 1, if it equal to 0, then y value will get is minus 1 by 2. And if y plus 1 equal to 0, then y value you get is minus 1. So you get the value, you will, because this is a quadratic equation, so you'll get two value of x, you'll get two value of y. So the two values of x, what you're getting here, those values are called root of the equation. So if you see your x value, x is either 1 minus 1 by 2 or x is either minus 3 by 2. Okay, and the y value, what you're getting is what? You're getting y as minus 1 or minus 1 by 2. So y value you're getting is minus 1 by 2 or you're getting minus 1. Anyone, any doubt? So I got the x value, I got the y value. Okay, I hope everyone understood. Nobody have any doubt. So you need to solve quadratic equation very basic. It won't be difficult. You need to solve the quadratic equation. You have to break the middle term in such a way that when you add, you should get the middle value. And when you multiply, you should get the product of A and C. So two values of x I get, two values of y you got, because it's a quadratic equation. The power of x, maximum power of x is 2 here. So it will give 2 value. So the graph, if you plot the graph, you studied in your PU standard and all, the graph of that would be parabolic. Okay, forget that parabola and all. Don't get scared. So it's same thing. So here if you compare x and y, if you see here your x is also minus 1 by 2 and y is also minus 1 by 2. So I can say x is equal to y. Okay. And then if you see x is here minus 1 by 2 and y is here minus 1. So what is bigger here? What is minus 1? Minus 1 by 2 is bigger or minus 1 is bigger? So you know that minus 1 by 2 is bigger. So I can say x is greater than y. Okay. Okay. Then what else? I can see the relation. So if I see x, if I take x is equal to minus 3 by 2. And if I take y is equal to minus 1 by 2, okay, then I can say that y is bigger than x. Okay, so then if I take x equal to minus 3 by 2 and y value equal to minus 1. So minus 1, 3 by 2 is minus 1.5. So again, I can say x is bigger than y. Sorry, y is bigger than x. So the ultimate relation, what I can say about x and y is x is either equal to y, okay, or here I'm getting x is greater than y or y is greater than x. So then I'm not getting any relation. I hope you're understanding. So I'm getting both scenario. So x is greater than y, also I'm getting x is less than y also. So this all I'm getting as a conclusion. So if you see the option, so ultimately the option which suits here is the option E, that x is equal to y and no relation can be established between x and y, because in some cases I'm getting x more than y, in other case I'm getting x y more than x. So I can't establish the relation between x and y. So either x is equal to y or either x is greater than y or y is greater than x. So this does not lead to me in any path. This is confusing. So either x would be greater than y or either y would be greater than x. But all that I'm not coming with a common conclusion. So ultimately the answer for that would be x is equal to y or no relation can be established. So this part is clear. Now see the question number 12. Again, like the same way you have to solve the quadratic equation. Break the middle term. So 16x square plus 16x plus 3 is equal to 0 and 9y square plus 27y plus 20 is equal to 0. So if you break the middle term, so when you add, you should get 16. When you multiply, you should get 16 threes are 48. This will be 16x square plus 12x plus 4x plus 3 equal to 0. So if you take common, you'll take 4x common. So you get 4x plus 3 plus 1. This is 4x plus 3 equal to 0. So you'll get 4x plus 1 into 4x plus 3 equal to 0. So ultimately the x value you'll get is minus 1 by 4 and minus 3 by 4. Here if you solve, break the middle term, you should get 189 into 20. 9 into 20 is 180. So you have to break the middle term in such a way, then when you add, you should get 27. So the value, so here I can write 12y plus 15y. 12y plus 15y. So 12 into 15 is 180, and 12 plus 15 is 27. So take common, we'll get 3y common. So this y plus 4. Here, if you take 5 common, you get 3y plus 4. So if you see, this is 3y plus 5. This is 3y plus 4 equal to 0. So the y value you'll get is minus 5 by 3 and minus 4 by 3. So now very simple. So x value, if you see the x value you're getting is minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 4, minus 3 by 4. So what is minus 1 by 4? I think you know that. 0.25. What is 3 by 4? 0.75. The y value what you're getting is what? Minus 5 by 3. Minus 5 by 3 and minus 4 by 3. So what is y value? Y value you're getting is minus 1.67 and minus 1.33. Now see this, guys, see. So in every case, the x is bigger than y. They are not equal. Minus 0.25 is bigger than both of them. Minus 0.75 is bigger than both of them. So in every case, x is bigger than y. Anyone, any doubt? Any question, anyone? Do you want to try this question? Question number 13. So this is 9x square minus 9x plus 2 equal to 0. Break the middle term. So this would be minus 6x minus 3x plus 2 equal to 0. So 3x you take common, 3x minus 2 minus 1, 3x minus 2 equal to 0. So you get 3x minus 1, 3x minus 2 equal to 0. X value is 1 by 3 and 2 by 3. So you get the x value. Now you solve the y value, 9y square minus 18y plus 8 equal to 0. 9 8 is 72. 72 12 and 6, right? 12 and 6, yeah. So minus 12y minus 6y plus 8 equal to 0. You take common, so 3y you take common, 3y minus 4, here you take common what? 2, right? So 3y minus 4. This is 3y minus 2 into 3y minus 4 equal to 0. So the y value you'll get is 2 by 3 and 4 by 3. See this. This is 2 by 3, 2 by 3, same. So x is equal to y. 2 by 3, 2 by 3, same. You get x equal to y. And this is 1 by 3, 2 by 3. So here you can see 4, 2 by 3 and 2 by 3, same. 4 by 3 is bigger than 2 by 3. Okay, so y is bigger than x. 1 by 3, 2 by 3. So y is bigger than x. 4 by 3, 1 by 3. Y is bigger than x. So y is bigger than x. So final answer is y is greater than or equal to x. Option D. Not option D. Sorry. Option A. Y is bigger than or equal to x. Very simple. You simply have to solve the quadratic equation. You work this out. So guys, these are very easy problem. If you are thinking these are difficult problem, but then I am really can say that there's a big problem with you. You need to do a lot of hard work, because this is something, the exam what I'm talking about is SBI clerk exam. Okay. And that too, in that exam, we are talking prelims round. So where you need to solve 2 minute one question. In that speed. So if you are saying that is a difficult problem, if you think it's a difficult problem, means there you need to do a lot of hard work. You need to do a reality check of yourself. Question number 14. If you see this, break the middle term. 49x square minus, sorry, plus 14x minus 3 is equal to 0. 49y square plus 56y plus 15 is equal to 0. 49 into 3 is 147. So find the factors of 147. One factor 147 is, if I divide by this 3, this is 4 is 29 into 7 and 7. So 14, 21 minus 7. Yeah. So I can write this as 59x square plus 21x minus 7x minus 3 equal to 0. Okay, so we get common 7x. If I take common, we'll get 7x plus 3. This is minus 1. 7x plus 3 equal to 0. So you get 7x minus 1. 7x plus 3 equal to 0. So the x value you'll get is 1 by 7 and minus 3 by 7. That you'll get as the x value. Now y value. So 49 into 15 is 135, and this is 60. This is 735. So 735, if you divide by 7, you will get 105. If you divide by 7, you will get 315. You will get 3. 7735. So you should get 56, right? So 49 and 15 will not work. So 35 and 21. So 35 and 21. So you can take common. 7y plus 5. So you'll get 7y plus 5 equal to 0. So y value you'll get is minus 3 by 7 and minus 5 by 7. So now if you see this, if you compare x and y here, so your x is equal to y, because minus 3 by 7, okay, then minus 3 by 7 minus 5 by 7, so x is more than y, okay, 1 by 7, is more, positive is always more than negative value. So x greater than or equal to option D. Anyone, any doubt? Any question, anyone? Okay, now see this question number 15. This is x cube. This is x cube is equal to 512 and 2y square is equal to 128. So y square is equal to 64. So y is equal to plus minus 8 and x is equal to 8. I hope you know this. Minus 8 square is also 64, and plus 8 square is also 64. And cube, I think you should be in position that you either remember the cube value or you should know that 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8, 3 cube is 27, 4 cube is 64, 5 cube is 125, 6 cube is 216, 7 cube is 343, 8 cube is 512, 9 cube is 729, 11 cube is 1331, 12 cube is 1728, 13 cube, 14 cube, all that you have to remember. So here x value you are getting is 8, y is either 8 or minus 8, plus 8 or minus 8. If you see here, x is 8 plus 8 and y is 8 also, and y is minus 8 also. So if x is 8, y is 8, so x is equal to y. Why? Because they are equal to 8. And if you see the another scenario also, x will be greater than y. Why? Because positive 8 is bigger than minus 8. So greater than x is either equal to y, x is either greater than y. Simple. Anyone, any doubt? Any question, anyone? So next question, question number 16. This is the problem of time and work. So time and work, if you are not very confident on time and work, you can see very recently I have made a video on time and work. You can go and watch the video, time and work. You can see 6 days before. So in this video, I have discussed all the concepts of time and work. It is around 1 hour video. So the two videos are there, 1 hour. There's another video of 20 or what, some minutes. So another video of 30 minutes. So around 1.5 hour video is there of time and work. I really suggest you go and watch these videos to understand if you are not very clear with time and work. So here if you see, A alone can do the work in 40 days. So if you give a work to A, A will do this work in 40 days. And the rate of efficiency of B to A is 5:4. So you can understand B is more efficient than A. The rate of efficiency is 5:4. This is the ratio of the efficiency is 5:4. So you should know that efficiency is inversely proportional to the number of days to do the work. So if you talk about time taken for B to A to do the work, that would be 4:5. Because if you are more efficient, you will do the work in less number of days. I hope you are understanding. And if less efficient, you will take more days. So efficiency is inversely proportional. Efficiency that will be inversely proportional to the number of days what you will take to do the work. Okay, so I hope you're understanding. So if you see here, the ratio B to A is 4:5, time taken. So if A is doing the work in 5x days, okay, so then B will do the work in 4x days. And that 5x is here given as 40 days. So you can find the value of 4x. So that would be how much? That would be 32 days. So if A can do the work in 40 days, then B can do the same work in 32 days. Then B can do the same work then in 32 days. So with that efficiency, I can find the time taken for each of them to do the work. Okay, once I do that, so once you're done with that part, so what you do, define work. So if A can do the work in 40 days, B can do the same work in 32 days. Here if I'm talking in the term of A and B, so here if I'm talking the term of A and B, so A is doing the work in 40 days, the same work B is doing in 32 days. So what you can do to solve the question, you can define a work in the term of LCM of 40 and 32. What is the LCM of 40 and 32? So the LCM of 40 and 32 is 8 into 4 into 5, that will be 160. So let the work is 160 unit. So let the work find the LCM of 40 and 32. So you divide by 8, you get 4 and 5. So let the work is 160 unit. So in every day, A will do 4 unit of work. And every day, the B will do 5 unit of work. And if they'll do together, then A and B in one day, they will do 9 unit of work. If you are not very clear with this concept, this how to all I'm doing, you can watch my video to understand that in much more better way. So if A started the work and worked for 15 days, every day A is doing 5 unit of work. Sorry, every day A is doing 4 unit of work. So every day here every day A is doing 4 unit of work. Every day here A is doing 4 unit of work. Okay, and A has worked for 15 days. So in 15 days, how much work A would have done? 4 into 5, 60 unit of work. Then A left. Then how many days B can do the remaining work? Every day the B do 5 unit of work. Every day the B do 5 unit of work. Okay, suppose B takes another X days to the remaining work. The total work is 160 unit. You just need to solve it. So 5x is equal to, this is 60, this is 100. X is equal to 20. So the answer for that is 20. So how many days B will do the remaining work? The answer is 20 days. Anyone, any doubt? Any doubt, anyone? Shruti? Question number 17. Rectangle square. You should be clear with rectangle, what rectangle, square, and all. When we say rectangle is a quadrilateral. So rectangle is a quadrilateral. So quadrilateral, when we talk quadrilateral is basically, it is a polygon make of four. So any polygon where the number of side is four, then it is called as quadrilateral. In quadrilateral, you should know what is parallelogram. In quadrilateral, you should know parallelogram. You should know trapezium, or you should know kite. In quadrilateral, you should know parallelogram, trapezium, kite. So this is like a kite. So when we talk kite, this and this side is the same. This and this side is same. In case of kite, you have diagonals, like diagonals would be perpendicular to each other, and one set of diagonal bisect the another set of diagonal. Okay, this is called kite. So the area of this kite is half into d1 into d2, where d1 and d2 are not same. Okay, this is kite. Now then this is trapezium. What is trapezium? This is called trapezium, where one pair of sides are parallel to the another pair of sides. So AB is parallel to CD, but AD is not parallel to BC. This is called trapezium. Okay, so this is called trapezium. So when we say trapezium, these non-parallel sides are called oblique sides. The sides which are non-parallel, we call them as oblique sides. And the area of the trapezium is half into sum of parallel side, that is AB plus CD into height. This is called trapezium. Okay, what is parallelogram? Parallelogram area is base into height. In case of parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel and equal. This is called parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel and equal. The diagonals of the parallelogram bisect each other. and the area of the parallelogram is base into height. Area of the parallelogram is base into height. This is called parallelogram. The diagonal of parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals may or may not be equal. Parallelogram in parallelogram we study two things. One is called rectangle and another one is called rhombus. So what is rhombus? Rhombus means all the sides are equal. This is rhombus. All sides are equal. Okay, sides are not perpendicular to each other. Diagonals are not equal. In rhombus, your diagonals are not equal. Diagonals are perpendicular to each other. In rhombus, your diagonals are perpendicular to each other. So this, I can write this as d1 by 2. This would be d2 by 2. And you can apply Pythagoras theorem. You can say a square is equal to d1 square, d1 by 2 whole square, d2 by 2 whole square. So you can say 4a square is equal to d1 square plus d2 square. You can remember area of rhombus is half into d1 into d2. Okay, that is the area of rhombus. Diagonals are not equal in rhombus. Okay, so when we say rectangle, what is rectangle? In case of rectangle, all sides are perpendicular to each other. When we say rectangle, opposite sides are equal and parallel. All angles are 90 degrees. In case of rectangle, the diagonals are equal. They bisect each other, but they do not bisect at the right angle. Okay, so area of the rectangle is length into breadth, and the perimeter of the rectangle is 2 into length plus breadth. That is rectangle. So when we have a polygon which have property of both rectangle and rhombus, that we call a square. So square is a parallelogram which have the property of both rectangle and rhombus. So in the case of square, all sides are equal. In case of square, all your sides are equal. When you say square, all your sides are equal. Your diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Diagonal bisect each other. Okay, so remember, in case of square, diagonal is equal to root 2a. Suppose a is the side of the square, so the diagonals are equal. Each diagonal is equal to root 2a. Suppose a is the side of the square, area of the square would be a square or half into d square, where d is your diagonal. Perimeter of the square would be 4 into a. Know the property of rectangle, rhombus, square, so it would be helpful for you to solve the problem. So if you see question number 17, area of square is equal to the area of rectangle, okay, and the length of rectangle is 8 centimeter more than the side of the square. So let the side of the square is x. Okay, and the length of rectangle is 8 centimeter more than the side of square, and the breadth is 6 centimeter less than the side of square. So the breadth is 6 centimeter less than the breadth is 6 centimeter less than the side of the square. The area is same. What is area of square? X square. What is area of rectangle? Length into breadth. We need to solve this. This is x square is equal to 8x minus 48 plus x square minus 6x. X square cancel. 8x, this is 2x. 2x is equal to 24. 2x is equal to 48. So x is equal to 24. So the length of the square you got is 24. So you want the perimeter of rectangle. So if x is 24, so length of rectangle would be 32 and breadth of rectangle would be 18. So L plus B is 50. So the perimeter formula is 2 into A plus B. Then this would be 100. Anyone, any doubt? See this question number 18. In an election of two candidates, 15% of vote were declared invalid. So 15% of vote are declared invalid. Suppose the total vote was X. So 15% is invalid. So invalid vote is 15%. Okay, so how much is the valid vote? Valid vote would be 85%. Okay, so then winner got 60% of valid vote. So winner, whoever is the winner, he got 60% of valid vote. So loser would have got how much? 40%. If winner got 60% of valid vote, the loser would have got 40% of valid invalid vote. So 85 fourza is what? 340, right? 85 fourza is 340. So and 85 sixza is what? 510. So yeah. So now what is the difference of the vote? Difference 17 threes are 51, 17 twos are 34. So the difference would be 0.17x. That difference is given as 1700. What is the value of x? What is the value of x? This is divided by 100, 0, 0. 10,000 would be the total number of vote. Understanding, right? So if the winner got 51% vote, then loser got 34% vote. So the difference is 17% vote. Winner won by 17% vote. 17% vote is 1700. The value of x is 100 into 100, means 10,000. The total number of vote which was polled in the election, that was 10,000. Anyone, any doubt? Any question, anyone? Anyone, any question? Anyone, any question? Please ask question. Any question, anyone? Is it simple or not? Do this question number 19, everyone. Everyone do question number 19. Everyone try question number 19. Very basic generic question you can do by yourself. Everyone please try question number 19. See this question number 19. There are some student in the class. Suppose the number student in the class is suppose n. And the number of chocolate received by each student is 1/6 of the total number of students in the class. So total number of students, so everyone got suppose n by 6 chocolate. So the total chocolate will be, then it would be n square by 6. Simple. Okay, so suppose the total number of students in the class is suppose n, and everyone is getting 1/6 of the total number of students. Means everyone is getting n by 6 chocolate. So total number of chocolate would be n square by 6. Okay. If the number student in the class become 1/3, if the number of the class, the number student in the class become 1/3, means if the number student become n by 3, then each student will get 27 chocolate. So now the total number of student would be 9n. Okay. But the total chocolate will remain same, right? So either student decrease or increase. So with this, you'll get the n value. N value is 54. So find the total number of chocolate distributed in the class. What is the total number of chocolate distributed in class? That would be what? The total number of chocolate to be distributed in the class, that would be what? 9 and what is the total number of chocolate distributed in the class? Either 9n or n square by 6. Either 54 square by 6 or either 54 9s are. So 9 4s are 36, 3 carry, 45 plus 3, 486. So the total number of chocolate distributed in the class would be 486. Very good, Jaina. Simple question, guys. So in wherever you, whichever exam you write in your life, whichever exam you're going to write in your life, if in that exam, if you're getting 2 minute or 3 minute or 4 minute or 1 minute to attempt one question, so the level of question would definitely would be very easy. Okay, this question number 20 and all, it came in CAT, it came in many exam. So you should know the approach, like in an alloy A yesterday also. Yesterday we did that problem, last problem, if you remember. Yesterday, the last problem, what we did, it was same like this, the last problem, what we did yesterday, same, the both were same only. If you see this problem, see this question number 24. So two cash containing liquid, mixture of liquid A and B. In first cash, the ratio of A is to B, 7:3. Second cash, it was 3:1. In what ratio the must the mixture from the two cash can be taken so that we get a ratio of A to B is 11:4. And you see this question. In alloy A, the zinc and copper are in ratio 1:1. Second alloy, the ratio of same element is 3:5. If these two alloys are mixed to form a new alloy in which zinc and copper are in ratio 2:3, what is the ratio in which alloy A and alloy B are mixed? Both same question. How to do these kind of questions? Shortcut way. So out of two elements, so these alloys are made of two elements, zinc and copper. Out of zinc and copper, you just take the proportion of any element. So suppose if I take zinc, so zinc is how much here? If you see zinc is here 1%. Okay, in alloy B, how much is the zinc? If you see alloy B, the zinc, ratio of zinc and copper is 3:5. So how much is the zinc here? 3/8. So in alloy A, your zinc is 50%. In alloy B, your zinc is 37.5%. That is 3/8. And when you're mixing them in the mixture, the ratio of zinc and copper is 2:5. So in the mixture, how much is your zinc? That is 2/5. So in the mixture, the zinc is 2/5. This is 40%. This is 37.5%. This is 50%. Now what you do, if you're mixing them, so you just do that allegation mixture. 50 minus 40, that is 10. 10 means 1/10. You simply do 1/2 minus 2/5. You do, you'll get 1/10. And this is what? This is 2/5 minus 3/8. You do, you'll get 2.5. 2.5 means 1/4 of 1/10. You'll get 1/40. So this is 1/10. This is 1/40. What is the ratio of A by B? A by B ratio 1/40 by 1/10. You get 1:4. The same way, if you would have done this problem, the same way you could have done this problem also, you would have got the same answer. I can't write it here. So same way, A and B, take anything, doesn't matter. You take A or B, doesn't matter. A here is 7/10. B here is 3/10. Okay. So A here is 7/10. B here is 3/10. So you just focus on one variable. A by 10. Here A would be 3/4. And when you're mixing the mixture, their A should be 11 by 15. You do it, you'll get the same answer, 1:2. So this here A is 7 by 10, 3 by 4. You do that. So 7 by 10, A is 7 by 10. Okay, so, and then A is 3 by 4. 7 by 10, then 3 by 4. And in the mixture, it should be 11 by 15. In the mixture, it should be 11 by 15. So if you want the ratio, this is 70. This would be more than, no? So this is 75 minus 7, 3 by 4 minus 11 by 15. 11 by 15, 66, that would be 70. This is 73.33%. This is 75%. This is 70. You just solve it, you'll get. And this is what? This is 11 by 15 minus 7 by 10. LCM is 30. 22 minus 21. You'll get 1 by 60. Here you'll get 1 by 60. So what is the ratio? Find the ratio. What would be the ratio? X is 2y. The ratio would be 1 by 2. So I hope you're understanding. It's not at all difficult. You can do it very easily. See this question number 21 and all. DI problem. How easy is the problems of DI? You can see. So the following bar graph shows the cost price of four different kinds of product. Find the difference in the sum of cost price of A and B. A and B, 290 plus 280. 290 tuza is 5. 29 tuza is 57, right? 58. So this would be 57. So this would be 570. And this would be 330 plus, this would be 600. What is the difference? Difference would be 30. Question number 20. Find the ratio of the sum of cost price of B and D. B and D, 280 plus 330. This is 610. The sum of, and with the cost price of C, that would be 330. So let's just be confirmed. 280 plus 270. That would be 550. That would be 550. This is 550. So this ratio will be 5:3. Option E. 23. If the question number 23. Very easy, right? Question 23. If the cost price of product B increased by 25%, the cost price of product B is 280. And it is increased by 25%. Increase 25% means what? 1 by 4? 1 by 4 if the 280 increase. So how much it will increase by 70 rupees? Simple. They're asking you that increase. Anyone, any doubt? Simple question, guys. Nothing can be more simpler than this. Here, sum of cost price of product A and C. Sum of cost price of product A and C, 290 plus 330. How much you'll get? This 5620. So 620. Sum of cost price of A and C together. At what percent more than the cost price of D? So this is how much percent more than the cost price of D? So this is what? 350. 350 is how much more than 270? So sum of cost price of A and C together, the 330 plus 290, so this would be 620. How much 620 is more than the cost price of product D? Means 3500 divided by 27. So this will get in decimal value. So you can solve, you will get 129 something. So approximately you'll get 130%. We can solve this 3500 divide by 27, 1s are 27. You will get 80, 27 2s are, 3s are is 81. So if you see 27 3s are is 81, so approximately you will get 130%. Otherwise 129.6 something percent you are getting. So all values are integer, so the answer would be 130%. Question number 25, average of the cost price of product B and C. So cost price B and C, 280 plus 330. So that is what? 610, right? 280 plus 330 is what? 610, average of this what? Average of cost price of B and C. What is the average of this? Average of this is 305. Okay, how much more or less than the average of cost price of A and D? A and D, 290 plus 270. So that would be 560, right? 560 divided by 2. That would be 280. So 305 is how much more or less than 280? Then it would be 25. Okay, now tell me the answer for this. Any question, any doubt you have, anything you want me to discuss again, guys? Any question you want me to discuss again, please tell me. I'll send you these questions in your group. You can see these questions. You can go through the video also. But before that, anything you want me to discuss again? Anywhere you found difficulty to understand? I hope you understand the level of questions are very easy. Tell me the answer, question number 26 answer. Guys, tell me. Think, how will you do that? Kishore, try again. Not the correct answer. Very good, Devika. Devika, can you tell the logic? 158 is the answer, guys. Devika, can you tell the logic to others? Or others can tell me the logic if the answer is 158. If I'm telling you the answer 158, so tell me the logic. The difference here, guys, see the difference here, 22 minus 13 is 9, then 36 minus 22, then this would be 14. Then see the difference, 60 minus 36, the difference would be what, 24, no? 24, see the difference again, this would be 39. So if you notice 9 plus, if you see the difference here is 5, see the difference is 10. If you see the difference is 15. Difference of difference. So 5, 10, 15, I got a pattern. So the difference of difference should be 20 here. It means this should be 59. So difference should be 59 here. Means your answer is 99 plus 59. The answer would be 158. Very good, Harish. So you can do anyway, you will get the answer 158. Okay, can we go ahead? Now do this problem. I don't know. I have no idea. So we use trial error method. I don't know how I'll get the answer. If I see the difference is 11. If I see the difference is 33. If I see the difference here, I'm getting 99. Then if I see the difference, this is 11, 3's are 33. 33, 3's are 99. And 99 threes is 297. If you see the difference, it is 297. Next difference will be 297 threes, 27, 22 carry, 891. So 891 plus 445. So 891, this 13, 1336. See the difference, the difference. So we need to be good with this, guys. Clear? Can I go to the next question? Do this problem. So I'll do this problem. This was very difficult to be done, frankly speaking. So this I will do. So you just see the number. So 6 into 0.5. Half of 6 is 3 plus 1 is 4. Then 4 into 1 plus 1, 0.5 increase. This is 5. Then 5 into 1.5. You can see the difference. This plus 1. 15, 5 is 75. This would be 8.5. Then 8.5 into 2 plus 1. You will get 18. And 18 into 2.5 plus 1. So 18 into 2.5 means 5 9s are 45, 46. The answer is for this is 18. So if you have any other way, you can most welcome to do by that way. Shruti, I wrote everything here, Shruti. So this is like, you need to find the relation, Shruti. It's like whatever the value is there, whatever is your previous value. So into here, you can see 0.5 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 1.5. You can see the difference here, Shruti. Difference 0.5, 0.5. 0.5, you're increasing that by 4.5. How will you get 4 from 6, then from 4, 5, then from 5, 8.5, the relation. The relation is like hook or crook, you need to find the relation. So 6 into 0.5 means half of 6. 0.5 means what? Half plus 1. You'll get 4. Then 4 and 5, how will you get the relation? 4 into 1. Increase it by 0.5. 0.5 increased by 0.5. So 1 plus 1. 4 into 1 is 4 plus 1, 5. Then 5. Then increase it by 1.5. Increase by 0.5. 1 if you increase by 0.5, become 1.5. 1.5 into 5 is 7.5 plus 1. You'll get 8.5. Again, 8.5, increase it by 0.5. You'll get 2 plus 1. You'll get 18. Then 18 increase by 0.5. This is 2. You'll get 46. So in actual exam, these kind of, any kind of relationship exists, guys. Doing this kind of missing frequency is very, very painful exercise. If you want, I'll give you questions on this missing frequencies. If you want, I'll give you 20-30 problems. You can practice by yourself. Nowadays, missing frequencies questions are very common in competitive exam. Do this question number 29. Do this question number 29. I don't know what can be the relation. So first thing what comes to my mind whenever I see this kind of question, I always find the difference. I have no idea how to do. So this is 13 minus 4. This would be 9. Then 31 minus 13. Then it would be 18. Then 67 minus 31. This would be 36. And then I don't know. So 9 to the 18, 18 to the 36, 36 to the 72. So how much I'll get? This is 9, 139. So I'll get 139. So 283 minus 139. I need to, whatever I'm thinking, then the next one should be 144. So if that is the case, then I'm correct. So this is 4, then 7 minus 3, 4, 144 means you are correct. The answer is 139. Yeah. So do this question number 30. Here, the difference here, you can see the difference 16 and 24, 8. Then 24 and 88, if I see the difference, this would be 64. If you see the difference, this would be 216. Then you see the difference, it would be 512. Then if you notice this difference, 2 cube is 8, 4 cube is 64, 6 cube is 216. 8 cube is 512. Then I believe you know the next thing would be 10 cube, that would be 1000. So the next difference should be 1000. The next number would be 1816. Now, guys, if you see the next question, so A sell it was to B at profit of 20%, B sell it to C at a loss of 15%. Yesterday we did one question like this. If you remember, we did that kind of question. So I hope you're understanding these kind of questions. Keep repeating. You can see this question number 14. These kind of question keep repeating in every paper. So A sell his watch to B. Suppose A bought this watch for X rupees and A sell to B at a profit of 20%. 20% profit means 1.2x. okay, to B, while B sell to C at a loss of 15%. So A cost price is suppose X, A selling price is 1.2X. Okay, A give to B, B cost price is 1.2X. So B selling price. So B sell to C at a loss of 15%. So loss of 15% means, guys, what? 15% loss, 10% loss, it would be 0.9. So 15% loss, then it would be 0.85. 0.85 into 1.2X. So 0.85 into 1.2X. So 12 5s are 60. 12 8s are 96. This is 0.1020 means 3 decimal 1.02X. Okay, these things, guys, you should be learned to please improve your speed. The topics like profit and loss, percentage, okay, ratio, proportion, time and work, these only will come in exam. Okay, then the C, the cost price for C is 1.02X. Okay, and C pays 2550 means 1.02X is 2550. 1.02X means 102/100X is 2550. So you can simplify this. This becomes 51/50X is 2550. So you can see this. So you can see this 51x by 50 is 2550. 51 5 is 255. So this is 50. So the value of x would be 2500. So the cost price at which A bought, then it would be 2500. Question is that at what price A sold to B? This is 2500, but in they're asking you this. So 20% profit, no? 25% of this is what? 500. This would be 3000. At what price A sold to B? That would be 3000. Any doubt? Any question, anyone? Anyone, any doubt? Are you understanding? So the cost price, that you solve the question, that is great thing. A really commendable job you did by solving the question. But here it not only about solving the question. The next thing is that what they are asking you in this question. So you have to find that. They are asking you at what price A sold to B. A bought for X, A sold for 1.2X. So find that value, 1.2X value. Now see the next question, question number 32. I believe everyone knows the formula of compound interest. Everyone knows the formula of compound interest, where the amount formula, when you see the amount formula, amount is equal to principal into 1 plus r by 100 to the power t. That is the amount formula. So amount formula. So here amount received on certain sum when compounded annually for 2 years is at r percent is 6480. So 6480 is the amount when it is compounded for 2 years. This is the equation. And for 3 years it is 7776. For 3 years it is 7776. This is what is given. This all normal is given to you. Simple formula, guys. Compound interest, simple interest. Already, I believe you know the formula of amount. You know the formula of interest. This all is given to you. Okay. So what do you need to find? You have to find the principal. Okay. So if I divide the equation from equation one, I get 776 by 6480 is equal to 1 plus R. To solve this, so 776 by 6480 minus 1 is equal to R by 100. So 776 minus 6480. This is 7. This is 9. This is 2. Then this is 1296. This is 1296 by 6480. So you can write 1296 by 648 is equal to R by 10. So 648 is 1296. Okay, so this, what is the R value? R is 20%. 648 is 6. So you get the R value. R value is 20%. I want the principal, guys. I get the R value. Can I find the principal? Yes, put that in any equation. 6480, you want principal. R is 20. 20 by 100 to the power 2. 6480 is equal to P. 20%. 20 by 100 is what? 1 by 5. You should be positioned. So 36 by 25 P is equal to 6480. So what is the value of P? P is 25. By 36. Solve this. So what is the value of P? 36 table or the 6 table, you know, right? 6 table, you know. So this is 6 table, if I know. So this will be what? This is 1080 by 6. And this is 180. So P is equal to 25 into 180. 25 is 100 by 4 into 180. This is 4 5. So your P is equal to 450. That is your principal. So you get principal as 450. See this question number partnership problem. Already I believe I have done partnership. Otherwise, if you are not very sure about how to attempt the problem of partnership and all, you are most welcome to watch my videos on partnership so that you understand the concept of partnership. Partnership is nothing but it is an application of a ratio and proportion where you have studied about partnership, right? In accountancy and all, you know, limited liability partnership, all that. So when we talk about partnership, in case of partnership, like different persons start a business by putting certain money for certain time period. So when we talk about partnership, in the case of partnership, when we talk about sharing of profit, so when we talk about how the profit will be shared, so that profit sharing will depend upon 3 factors. One factor is your initial investment, how much money you're putting into that business. Next factor is the time period, how long you're putting that money into the business. And the third factor is the nature of involvement into the business. So how you are involved into the business. So are you a working partner or you're a sleeping partner? I don't know in accountancy what all you have studied under partnership. I'm talking about concept of aptitude. In aptitude, when we talk about sharing of profit and partnership, it depends upon 3 factors. It's actually compound ratio of your initial investment into your time period of your investment and your nature of involvement into the business. So here if you see A and B, so A has put 10,800 rupees into the business and B has put 18,900 to feed into the business. Okay, so both of them had stayed invested for 1 year, and C joined the business after 6 months with 16,200 rupees. So this is the money what they have put, and the time period: A invested for 1 year, B invested for 1 year, and C invested for half year. So the profit sharing, when we talk about the value of the investment, so that value of investment depends upon how much money you put and how long you put that money. So that is a compound ratio, means you multiply them. So this is 18,900 and this is 8,100. So that depends on these two parameter. This is 0,0. So this is 18 one carry, 17 one carry, 37,800. So now how much profit A will get? So the profit what A will get, that will be 16,000. So the profit what A will get, that will be 10,800 divided by 37,800 into the total profit of the company. Okay, how much profit B will get? That would be 18,900 divided by 37,800 into the profit of the company. The profit what C will get, how much profit does C will get? So the profit what C will get is 8,100 divided by 37,800 into profit of the company. So means here you need to understand that A, B, C, they will divide their profit. The profit, the ratio in which A, B, C will divide the profit, that would be in this ratio 108:189:81. So they'll divide their profit in this ratio. Okay, so if you want, you can make it more simpler. Okay, you can make it more simpler. You can make it 36:63:27. You can make it more simpler. 36. Again, it will go by. So ratio, this will go 12:21:9. And again, 4:7:3. So the ratio in which A, B, C, and what ratio they'll divide their profit, that would be 4:7:3. Okay, the total sum is 14. So if the C get a profit of this much, what is the total profit? So what is the profit what C will get? That would be 3/7 of the total profit, 3/14 of total profit. That is 21,000. Okay, so you can find this value. 7,000. So the total profit will be 98,000. Very good, Arish. So here, when we look into the business, a lot of questions are there on partnership. You can see like partnership. So when we talk about partnership, so you can see if you want partnership problem, I have my videos also in partnership. You can go through around all these questions I have discussed. Around 15 questions are there I've discussed in my video. You can go through my videos there on partnership. So if you have any doubt, still like if you feel that still I'm not satisfied, I want more questions. So you can go through my videos on partnership. You'll understand automatically everything. So now see this question number 34. If you see this question number 34, let the A age is A, present age of A. Always, whenever you solve the problem on ages, every exam will definitely get the problem on age. Let the present age of A is A, and present age of A mother is suppose M. Okay. So 5 years ago, the age of A mother, so 5 years ago, mother age would be M minus 5, A age would be A minus 5. The present age of A is A, present age of mother is M. So 5 years ago, the age of A mother is 3.5 times of age. So this I can write m minus 5, 3.5 I can write 7 by 2, a minus 5. So this cross multiply 2m minus 10 is equal to 7a minus 35. I can write 2m is equal to 7a minus 25. This I get one equation. Then, and 10 year hence, after 10 year, mother age would be m plus 10. So mother age would be m plus 10 and a would be a plus 10. 10 year hence, the ratio of a mother to a age, okay, they're asking, they're giving you the ratio. They're giving you the ratio that is 2 is 2. M plus 10 is equal to 2a plus 20. So I can write m is equal to 2a plus 10. So I can write 2m is equal to 4a plus 20. So then I can equate both the equation. So 7a minus 25 is equal to 4a plus 20. So I can write 3a is equal to 45. A is equal to 15. So a age is 15 and mother age. Mother age would be what? You can find mother age by this equation. 2a plus 10. 2a. 2a means 30 plus 10, 40. What is the sum of the ages? That would be 55. Okay, everyone. Then you see this question number 35. So you see this, two trains are there. So if the speed is given in kilometer per hour, I hope you know how to convert the speed in meter per second. So if your speed is given to you at 93 kilometer per hour, So to convert the speed, which is in kilometer per hour, into meter per second, multiply this with 5 by 18. So if you multiply this with 5 by 18, you will get the value in meter per second. Okay, so this would be 31. This would be 6. Okay, so this would be 155 by 6 meter per second. That is the speed of A, correct? And the speed of B is given as 57 kilometer per hour. This is 57 kilometer per hour. If you want to convert this into meter per second, so this would be 19. This would be 2. This would be 95 by 1. So, sorry, 1 minute. So 19 threes are 57, and 19s are 57, 3 6 are 18, 95 by 6 meter per second. So actually two trains are given to you. The speed were given in kilometer per hour. So guys, this is the problem. This is the question on problem on train. So if you want problem on train questions and all, I'll send you a lot of questions on problem train. You can solve it. Let me know what is your requirement. So whenever we are trying to solve the problem on train, let me know which all topic you are feeling weak. We can focus more on those topics. So whenever you're solving problem on train, we prefer to solve the question in meter and seconds. So we prefer to take the data in meters and second. So while considering the problem on train, we consider the length of the train, we consider the length of bridge, we consider the length of platform. While we do not consider the length of a person, while we do not consider the length of electric pole. Okay, so then we simply use the formula of distance is equal to speed into time. Yeah, the formula what you need to use is distance. We need to use the formula that distance is equal to speed into time. I believe you know the concept of relative speed. that when two objects move in opposite direction, if the two objects move in opposite direction, the speed is A, the speed is B. What is the relative speed between them? That would be A plus B. Okay. While if the two objects move in same direction, if this is going at B and this is going at A, and if A is bigger than B, then the relative speed between them, this would be A minus B. Okay, so I believe you know these concepts very well. If you don't know, you need to watch my videos on time, speed and distance. Okay, to understand the concept of relative speed, the two objects when it moves in opposite direction, or when the two objects move in same direction. So you can use those concepts, and with that you can solve this question. Can you try to do this question, everyone? Do you want to try? Do you want to give a shot? Let's see who can give me the answer for this problem. We discuss about problem on train. If the two trains are there, the speed of this is A, the speed of this is B. The length of this train is L1 meter. The length of this train is L2 meter. Okay, the time for them to cross each other. So the time for them to cross each other, that would be L1 plus L2 divided by A plus B. The relative speed, they're moving in opposite direction. So the relative speed would be A plus B, and the total distance would be L1 plus L2. Similarly, if the two trains are moving in the same direction, suppose the length of this train is L1, this is going at speed A. There's another train is there of length L2, and this is going at B. So this is going at the speed B. Both are moving in the same direction. So if this train want to cross this train, like, so if the, suppose this is second train, okay, and this is suppose first train. Suppose second train want to cross the first train. Suppose if the second train want to cross the first train, then only possible if the speed of second train is more than the speed of the first train. So this is only possible if the speed of second train is more than the speed of first train. And if the speed of second train is more than the speed of first train, both are moving in same direction. So the relative speed between them would be A minus B. And the time for them to cross each other would be L1 plus L2 divided by A minus B. So you need to understand this parameter, everyone. Anyone, any doubt, you need to understand when the two train cross each other in opposite direction, if the two train cross each other in the same direction. Anyone, any doubt, any question? Anything you want to ask? Guys, please reply. I'm finding pin drop silence. Are you people understanding? Are you aware about the concept of relative speed? So you should understand this. So now we know the value of the speed of two trains. Here in this scenario, the A is what, 155 and 95, 155 and 95. So A is 155 by 6 meter per second. B is 95 by 6 meter per second. Okay. Now you see this problem. Now they're moving in same direction. And so they're moving in same direction. They cross each other in 18 seconds. So the length of the two train, because they're moving in same direction, so the relative speed between them would be A minus B, and the time they'll take to cross each other, that is equal to 18 seconds. The time is 18 seconds. So L1 plus L2, so 155 minus 95 by 6 into 18. So L1 plus L2 is equal to, this is what, this is 60, no? This is 60 into 3, right? This is 3, sir. That is 180 meter, right? The length, sum of length of two train is 180 meter. So I got the value. Okay. Then what they're asking me, what find the time taken for them to cross each other when they're running in opposite direction. So if they run in opposite direction, then the relative speed between them, that would be 155/6 plus 95/6. So that would be what? 160 plus 90 is 250. The relative speed between them is 250 by 6 meters per second. They're asking us the time for them to cross each other. So then the time would be L1 plus L2 is equal to A plus B into whatever. That is 180, right? This is 180. This is 180. So this is 155 plus 95. Right? This is 10. Okay, this is 260. 14, no, no, this is 250. This is 250 by 6 into T2. So if you want the time, 0, 0, I can cancel. This would be 18, 6 is what? 108, right? 108 by 5, 25. That would be the time. So I can write this as 25 fosa is 100. 48 by 25 seconds, no? Yeah, because we are doing everything in meter and second. So answer would be 48 by 25 seconds. The answer for that would be option A. Any doubt, anyone? Anyone, any doubt? Did you understand this concept? So these all questions came in SBI Clerk 2020. These all are the questions which came in SBI Clerk 2020. We discuss these questions which came for SBI Clerk 2020. The question notification for this exam is already out. You can go to the SBI website. You can go to SBI website, Google it. Go to the SBI website or SBI career, SBI notification 2021. I sent you PDF also with the link of SBI is there. So please go to that website. Okay, go to the website of SBI or SBI career. You can type in Google. Go and fill the online. You can fill the form of SBI. So you can see this. So recruitment of junior associate, customer support, and online registration. Click there. Please go to this link. Go to this link, click there and fill the form. I sent you the PDF, everything. So please make sure that you fill the form. The purpose of doing this class is to give you enough confidence that you can easily go through and clear these exam, the prelims exam, at least you can easily clear. So you should not face any problem. Go to any website, doesn't matter. Read about them, understand all the details. The exam for you will happen in June last week. Make sure that you fill the form of the exam. If you see Karnataka, in Karnataka, we have 64 opening for SC, 28 opening for ST, OBC 108 openings, general category 160 openings, around 400 openings are there, right? So total 5,000 some number opening are there all over India. You can see the exact data, 5,454 opening is there in all over India. And because we are from Karnataka, so when we'll fill the form, so we have around 400 seats. So for Karnataka students, so please make sure you utilize this specifically. Like I'm from Chhattisgarh, if I fill the form, I only compete for 120 seat out of 5,454. And if you're from Karnataka, you'll be eligible for 400 seats out of 5,454. So please fill this form, understand the importance, make sure you get the best of that. So it's time to wind up the class. I hope you have understood what all we have done so far in this class. So with that intention, if nobody have any doubt, I'd like to wind up the class. Anyone, any question you want?